Hey guys, today the video is about the main engine starting air valve exchange. Now this is a component of the main engine that is mounted on the cylinder head, and depending on what the problem is, it could be just that the equipment has run the full length of 32,000 hours running and that's why we need to change it, or it could also be that there has been a problem with it and that's why we're going to change it. We will switch to the video now in a bit. Before that, I just want to give some information. First is, of course, that this was done on a ship, so it's a little bit shaky in terms of the camera, so sorry about that. And second is, this is a MAN BMW engine. Although MAN, Sulzer, Mitsubishi all have similar concept in terms of design, but just to let you know, this is a MAN BMW engine. All right, to the video now.
This is the overhauled starting air valve, which will be installed in the cylinder head pocket. Now, before installation, the pocket has to be inspected as well for any carbon deposits or oil traces, etc. The two studs act like a guide to install the valve, and the nuts and washers keep it secured in place during working. In this exploded view of the cylinder head, the numbers 14, 26 and 36 are what I'm talking about. Along with the pocket, one also needs to check the old valve for the extent of carbon deposit, any physical damage, etc. The valve head has dedicated lifting holes where you should mount the eye bolts. Now, to extract the valve from the cylinder head, I use a chain block in combination with the engine room overhead crane. I do this because I feel it gives me a better control to assess whether the valve is stuck or free to move. When you heave using a chain block, you are basically doing it manually. And based on your experience, you would know how hard or easy this is supposed to be. But the same can't be said about using the crane directly. If the valve is stuck or seized while pulling, it could even damage the crane or the cylinder head, and then a small routine overhaul becomes a much bigger problem. Well, now the old starting air valve has been extracted and the new one is overhauled and ready to be installed. All that's required to be done is to exchange certain fittings from the old to the new. Also, with respect to the pocket, make sure that the landing seat and the ceiling contact surfaces are absolutely clean and without any trace of carbon. Ah yes, this is the pilot air connection, which also has to be removed from the old one and put on the new. This image has a short explanation about the working of the valve itself. All the steps are from the manual, and if everything goes as per plan, then it takes around 1 hour from start to finish for the routine maintenance.
Alright guys, so that was something about the main engine starting air valve exchange. Basically, we just put a new one and took the old one out. And during the video, I explained about some things that I do, as in the use of the crane in combination with the chain block. It's a very straightforward process, doesn't take very long, but just everyone has their own style of doing something, and over the years of doing this, I just felt that maybe this is the best combination for me. If you have any other ideas to do this, do share it in the comments. It is nice, of course, because as engineers, we always know that someone out there would have an easier way to do this, and it's always nice to share the idea. So if you have something like that, please do share it with us. And along with that, if you found this video useful, give me a thumbs up. And if you like this kind of content, then do subscribe to the channel. All right, thanks for watching and good day.